बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स. वी हैव स्टार्टेड बायोकेमिस्ट्री चैप्टर नंबर 21 ऑफ योर केमिस्ट्री बुक. आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज अबाउट प्रोटीन्स. प्रोटीन्स आर बायोकेमिकल मॉलिक्यूल्स. दे आर मेजर स्ट्रक्चरल कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ एनिमल्स एंड ह्यूमन टिश्यूज. दे आर पॉलीमर्स ऑफ अमाइनो एसिड यूनिट्स. नंबर ऑफ अमाइनो एसिड इन प्रोटीन्स रेंज फ्रॉम 2 to several thousand. What is amino acid? As you have already studied at matric level, and the formula of amino acid is this one. A central carbon is linked with a carboxylic group, an amino group, an alkyl group, and hydrogen on other side. Now, alkyl group is what you must remember, that it can be methyl, it can be ethyl, and propyl, and so on. And it is necessary that there should be at least one carboxylic group in the structure and one amino group in the structure. So the molecules of proteins, they contain nitrogen, carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. They act as biological catalysts, which are known as enzyme. We will study in detail it later on. They form structural part of organism, participate in cell signal and recognition factors, and act as molecules of immunity. Protein can also be used as source of fuel. Now, what we are going to study next is the classification of proteins. Proteins can be classified into three categories: simple proteins, conjugated proteins, and derived proteins. What are simple proteins? These proteins on hydrolysis yield two amino acids, only amino acid or their derivative. Means when they are broken down, hydrolysis means when they are broken down into their component on reaction with water, then they yield what? They yield amino acid or derivative of amino acid. Aur aisi protein ki example hamare paas kya kya hai? Albumins hai, globulins hai, glutulins and histones. Then we have conjugated proteins. These proteins which are attached or conjugated some non-protein group. Aur us non-protein group ko hum kya kehte hai? Prosthetic group. Prosthetic group is what? Non-protein part of a protein. So conjugated protein, in which conjugation is done between a protein part and a non-protein part. For example, nucleoproteins, mucoproteins, glycoprotein and phosphoprotein. And the last category is derived protein. These proteins which are derived from simple and conjugated protein. Yani in dono simple or conjugated protein ke कॉम्बिनेशन से डिराइव हो या किसी एक से डिराइव हो, उसको हम डिराइव प्रोटीन कहते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, प्रोटीन्स, प्रोटियोसिस, पेप्टोन्स एंड पेप्टाइड्स. स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ प्रोटीन्स. द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ प्रोटीन डिपेंड्स अपॉन स्पेशल अरेंजमेंट ऑफ पॉलीपेप्टाइड चेन्स. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय स्पेशल? मीन इन स्पेस. व्हाट इज द 3D अरेंजमेंट ऑफ पॉलीपेप्टाइड चेन्स प्रेजेंट इन प्रोटीन? Now, what is this polypeptide chain? Beta, you have studied already in your matric class that when at least two amino acids, they join together, they link together, and how this linkage is developed, that hydroxyl group of one amino acid, hydrogen of another amino acid, they together linked as water, and this water molecule is removed and result in a formation of linkage between these two amino acids. As you can see, NH2, NH2, CRH, CRH, C double bond O, C double bond O of this amino acid, then NH of this amino acid, CHR and carboxylic group. Now this linkage, this bond which has linked these two amino acid groups together is known as peptide linkage, and this chain is known as dipeptide, as it is formed by the combination of two amino acid. If it is formed by the combination of three, then it will be known as tripeptide. If there were four, then it will be known as tetra, and for many it will be known as polypeptide. Now it must be clear to you what is this polypeptide. As we have said, that it is the special arrangement of polypeptide chains in the space. Now due to this arrangement, there are four structural phases of protein. Number one is the primary structure of protein. primary structure is what? The sequence of amino acid and a peptide chain, as I told you and explained to you, is called primary structure. That is, formation of polypeptide chain is the primary structure. Amino acids are linked with one another through peptide bond, and the arrangement of these acids is called the primary structure, as it is shown over here in your book. This is the primary structure. Primary structure, amino acid sequence. Okay, the secondary structure of protein is peptide chain may acquire spiral space, spiral shape, or may be present in a zigzag manner. This coiling or zigzagging of polypeptide chain is called secondary structure of protein, and it is due to hydrogen bonding. Now you can see the secondary structure. Now in this secondary structure, zigzag arrangement or coiling is being done, and how this linkage is being developed due to hydrogen bonding, and this is known as alpha helix or secondary structure of protein. Third phase is the tertiary structure of protein. Twisting or folding of polypeptide chain represent tertiary structure of protein. Now this is the tertiary structure of protein, in which folded individual peptide, this peptide linkage, this peptide chain, it is now getting folded. It is being folded now. And again, in this hydrogen bonding and different linkages, they are involved. Next is the quaternary protein. Quaternary mean four, and this is the fourth phase in the creation of a protein. Quaternary protein is the arrangement of multiple folded protein or coiling protein molecule in a multi subunit complex. And here a variety of bonding can be observed. Hydrogen bonding will be there, salt bridges will be there, and disulfide bonds will be there to hold the various chains into a particular geometry. Proteins play an important role in the formation of protoplasm. And protoplasm, you know, is the basic or essence of all forms of life. Every cell contains protoplasm in it. Then nucleoproteins, which is an example of conjugated protein. They are complex protein and act as a carrier of heredity from one generation to another. Enzymes are the biological catalyst, and they are also protein in nature. Without enzyme, life is not possible. Hemoglobin, which is present in our blood, it is also a protein, and it act as a carrier of oxygen. Some of the protein, they act as hormones. They carry out the regulatory function of the body. Proteins have great importance in the industry. The tanning of hides is the skin of animals, is an industrial process. The process is the precipitation of protein by tannic acid. Hides is what, as I told you, skin of animals. Leather industry mein jab skin of animals ko tan kiya jata hai, to us process mein bhi protein use hote hain, aur usme proteins ke through tannic acid ko precipitate kiya jata hai. Gelatin is used by heating bones, skins. Gelatin is obtained by heating bones, skins and tendons in water, and it is used in bakery goods. Casein protein is used in the manufacture of buttons and buckles. Proteins obtained from soya bean are used for the manufacture of plastic. So beta, this is all about proteins, and short questions can be asked from this topic. Classification of proteins can be asked in detail. You must know how to draw them and what is their detail. So this is all about proteins. Next topic is enzymes. Enzymes are what? Biocatalysts. That is, they speed up metabolic activities in living bodies. They are protein in nature. They are specific in their actions. They are sensitive to temperature and pH. Now beta, we have said metabolic activities. Now the metabolism can be divided into further two categories, anabolism and catabolism. During anabolism, larger molecules, they are synthesized, that is, they are formed, and energy is used in this process. And during catabolism, larger molecules, they break down and energy is released. So both process, they go on side by side. Larger molecules, they are synthesized, they are also broken down. Then new larger molecules, they are formed in anabolism, and during catabolism they break down. And together both these activities, they make what? Metabolism. And to speed up metabolism, the enzymes, they play their important role. They are the catalyst, and as they speed up the reaction in living things, so they are known as biocatalysts. Now, enzymes are proteins that catalyze, that is speed up biochemical reaction, and are not changed during the reaction. They themselves are not changed during the reaction. The molecules at which enzymes act are called substrate. वो molecule जिस पे आपने enzyme apply किया है उसको कहते हैं substrate. And the enzyme then convert the reacted molecules into products. Now how do enzymes work? There are two different theories about the working of enzymes. Two different scientists, they put forward their concept. Generally, how enzyme work? Enzyme, which is symbolically represented as E, combines with S. S is what? Substrate. Then they form a complex, ES complex, of enzyme and substrate, and then they are separated into enzyme and product. The substrate is now converted into product, and enzyme is not changed during the reaction. Now, according to the first theory, which is known as lock and key model, this lock and key model is represented by a German chemist, Emil Fischer, in 1894, and he proposed this lock and key model. According to this model, both enzyme and substrate, they possess specific shapes that fit exactly into one another. And this model explains the enzyme specificity. As you can see in this figure, that this is the blue one is an enzyme, and red one is the substrate molecule. They fit together into each other. ES complex is formed, and then this ES complex, it breaks down. Enzyme is separated and remain unchanged, and the substrate is converted into product. Now another theory, another model, which is represented to explain the working of enzyme, was represented by an American biologist, Daniel Koshland, in 1958. He suggested a modification of lock and key model and proposed an induced fit model. Now, according to this induced fit model, active site is not rigid in structure. Rather, it is molded into required shape. यानी जो active site enzyme की वो fix एक ही shape में नहीं रहती, बल्कि वो requirement के मुताबिक अपने आप को mold कर लेती है, change कर लेती है, और अपने function को properly perform करती है. Induced fit model is more acceptable than the lock and key model for of enzyme action. For example, you can see in this figure that this is an enzyme, this is a substrate. You can see the active site of enzyme do not exactly match with the substrate site, but this enzyme site can be molded according to the substrate. So the substrate, it exactly fits into this enzyme. So this is induced fit model of enzyme action, and was represented by American biologist. What are the factors affecting enzyme activity? The first factor is temperature. Now, temperature and rate of enzyme catalyst reaction, they are directly proportional to each other. If you increase temperature, the rate of reaction also increase. But this is up to a certain limit, up to a certain specific temperature. And that specific temperature is in fact the maximum temperature, highest temperature. And that temperature is known as optimum temperature for a certain enzyme. For that certain enzyme which you are studying. Now if we plot a graph between temperature and rate of a reaction, then what we observe that as we raise the temperature, the rate of reaction is going to increase. Heat is added, activation energy is increased, so the rate of reaction also increase. But when it reaches up to its peak, that is maximum temperature, then after that temperature, on increasing temperature further, the rate of reaction does not increase. Rather, it starts decreasing. Why it starts decreasing after this optimum temperature? Because enzyme become denatured. After that temperature, enzyme become डीनेचर्ड, उसके वर्किंग ही इफेक्टेड हो जाती है. एज यू कैन सी फ्रॉम योर बुक ऑल्सो देर इज अ ग्राफ. इन दिस ग्राफ यू कैन सी द रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन इज राइजिंग विद राइजिंग टेम्परेचर रीचिंग अप टू मैक्सिमम टेम्परेचर विच इज द ऑप्टिमम टेम्परेचर फॉर ह्यूमन बॉडी इज 37 डिग्री. देन ऑन फर्दर इंक्रीजिंग टेम्परेचर द रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन स्टार्ट डिक्रीजिंग बिकॉज द एंजाइम बिकम डी नेचर. नाउ व्हाई द एंजाइम बिकम डी नेचर, हियर इट इज मेंशन्ड, बिकॉज वेल अबव द ऑप्टिमम टेम्परेचर हीट एनर्जी इंक्रीजेज द वाइब्रेशन ऑफ एटम्स ऑफ द एंजाइम एज वेल एंड द ग्लोबुलर स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एंजाइम इज लॉस्ट. This is known as denaturation of enzyme and it results in a rapid decrease in the rate of enzyme action and it may be blocked completely. Now the next factor is substrate concentration. Substrate was what? The substance under study on which you are applying the enzyme. Now if enzyme molecules are available in the reaction, increase in the substrate's concentration increases the rate of reaction as well. So we can say that rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction catalyzed reaction is also directly proportional to concentration of substrate. If we increase it, it will also be increased. Both are directly proportional to each other. So you can see it in the graph also, in the figure. Here you can see a graph is plotted between substrate concentration and enzyme activity. You keep on increasing the concentration of substrate, the rate of reaction also increases until it reaches a maximum rate. And then it becomes constant. Why it becomes constant? Because now no more active sites of enzymes are available. All active sites of enzymes, they are already occupied. No free active site is available. That is why the rate of reaction, it becomes constant. And the next factor is pH. pH also affects the activity of enzyme. All enzymes, they work at their maximum rate at a narrow range of pH called as the optimum pH. A slight change in this pH causes retardation in enzyme activity or blocks it completely. Every enzyme has its specific optimum pH value. For example, pepsin, which is present in stomach, is active in acidic medium, that is low pH, while trypsin working in small intestine show its activity in alkaline medium. Now a graph is also plotted between pH and the rate of reaction. With increase in pH, rate of reaction is also increased, reaching at a maximum point, that is optimum pH. After that it start decreasing if we increase the pH. So this is how different factors it affect the enzyme activity.